Grinding is a key part of the sharpening process, and every woodworker's sharpening workflow needs to include a method that is efficient and accurate to reduce the time needed to grind a blade. Grinding is necessary to regrind the primary bevel on a blade to either repair blade damage or to re-establish a fresh bevel for honing. Grinding to remove a nick in the blade should start with removing the nick, either on a grinder or on a coarse media choice such as a diamond stone or sandpaper. Be sure to keep the blade perpendicular during the grinding to avoid introducing a skew to the blade. Grinding is also required to re-establish the primary bevel after the secondary bevel becomes too large, and it is no longer efficient just to hone the secondary bevel. For many woodworkers, this means the bevel needs to be reground every 10 to 15 honings. Many options exist to grind a bevel, and a woodworker can use either power or manual methods to grind a blade. With grinding, the amount of material to remove is much greater than with regular honing, so coarse abrasives are the way to go. Power options include purpose-made sharpening setups, which are very efficient at quickly removing the material necessary to achieve a proper bevel. The greatest risk in using power for grinding is overheating the blade and losing the temper in the steel. This can happen long before the steel changes color, so once the blade becomes too hot to touch, a cooling period is recommended. Bench grinders can also be used with many options for tool rests and alignment aids to ensure the perfect primary bevel is achieved. Workshops that sharpen several times a day or busy school shops will want an efficient power sharpening solution to minimize time spent on this important phase of sharpening. Manual methods of grinding use all the same media and fixtures as honing, so this is often the method most woodworkers start out with. Hand methods may be slower than power methods. However, blades are less likely to be damaged with plenty of time for correction with slower methods. Set the blade in the honing guide on the primary bevel angle setting desired and grind away. The time it takes to grind is related to the coarseness of the media used. If you choose to use a regular stone of around 1,000, it may take a very long time to regrind the bevel, which is why having a coarser media available is necessary. A coarse diamond plate is one option that can also serve to flatten water or ceramic stones while making an efficient grinding option. A less expensive option is using sandpaper stuck to a flat surface such as glass or granite. Using PSA paper or a quick spray of adhesive holds the paper in place while grinding. It is also necessary to remove the filings as they accumulate to keep the fresh abrasive exposed. The size of the grit to use is a trade-off with how long it takes to remove the scratches from the very coarse grits. For this reason, the coarsest grit should be 80 to 100 and quickly switch into a finer grit when the bevel is close to complete. This will finish the grinding and remove the extra deep scratches at the same time. What level of grit to grind the primary bevel to is a personal choice, as it is the secondary bevel that actually does the cutting. Although deep scratches from grinding should be removed to not interfere with the secondary bevel. So it is often recommended to finish the primary bevel with a minimum of a medium stone, such as a 600 diamond or a 1000 grit water or ceramic stone. With the primary bevel established, it's time to hone the edge.